This is part of my building a car out of netting, and this is the 1891 white VS2V, and you can see that I have, this is a woven panel, it's about maybe a quarter of an inch thick, but this is a knit panel, which is quite thick, not quite a half an inch, but almost, and I actually have another layer that these pieces need to be put down in a layer. I thought I was going to be able to get through all three, but I won't. Now again, this is a project I'm doing that has to do with PTSD and building this big car, and I've already made a couple of changes to it. I'm going to use one of my bed rolls and make the bedroll into like a car. And then I can just take the whole bedroll, lay it out, put the bear on it. But let me show you how this works. Now I have the modern brother. I have 237s, I have 66, a 99. Some of them are packed up already. But I know the white itself can go through this without a problem. And as you can see, there is no problem with the machine sewing. The problem comes in, even through these thick layers. What the problem is keeping the yarn under the presser foot. So as you can see, this takes a little bit more attention than you would normally give maybe a now that ended up being like a basting stitch because I had left the presser foot lever up. So now let's see how it does. I have to go over that anyway because I didn't lock the stitch. Let's see how it does going sideways. This is the most annoying part of working with knits, heavy knits, and wovens. But I still know that this white has the best clearance for this. And it's just that every once in a while you have to stop, make sure the yarn is under the presser foot, and then continue. Now, see how when you leave the presser foot lever up, you get like a basting stitch. So it would still, and if this weren't so thick, I'd have loops of thread and everything under there. But it didn't work that way this time, and this time it came out okay. But you can see how, even though this is such an old, simple machine, this actually has a better clearance either when the presser foot is up for getting the fabric under there. This is very thick and it goes under there quite easily, and then the needle clearance as well. So that's really how the machine would be when you're pushing this under there. Now I made my sweater quilt on the 1588 and the brother, the Singer 1588 and the brother, and I felt at that time the 1588 was better because it had a hinged foot, but this one without any fabric layer and with just knits, this is going through it wonderfully.